This is a programme, quote, that raised its game on a station at the heart of a troubled community. The goal goes to Mike Parr's breakfast show at BBC Radio Cumbria.
Good.
News breaks anywhere and at any time. BBC Radio Cumbria was the first on the scene at the Lockerbie disaster. One of our reporters, Martin Lewis, was helping to make sure comments made at Lockerbie made it onto the airwaves, not just here, across Britain, but also across the world.
Well, the call came in just as we were getting ready to go off for our office Christmas party. We broadcast all night, but in fact, and it was Bert's report that led the 9 o'clock news that dreadful night.
And the same happened with Greyrig.
Indeed, yes. I was called out from home on the Friday evening. Again, it was my reports which went on 5 Live and so forth through the night from the telephones of local homes.
In 2001, the foot and mouth outbreak became one of the biggest national and international news stories.
I can see that both fires burning and it's just black belching smoke, which is horrifying to watch, knowing what's at the bottom of that fire. It's a lifetime's work for both those farmers.
In 2005, the world watched as Carlisle was hit by floods.
It has been confirmed that there are 50,000 people without power across the county. We'll be talking to United Utilities.
The water extends halfway up the length of the church there. Obviously, I haven't been down to the motorway end of Warwick Road yet. I don't know quite how far the water goes. It will be all the way to Tesco, certainly.
There's one here from Pete. It says, I live in a spatria and I had a cow blown through my patio doors. I've currently tied it up in the garden.
In 2009, another flood hit Cumbria, killing a policeman and devastating Cockermouth.
I'm here in Market Square in Cockermouth, where emergency services are knocking door to door rescuing residents. Further down the road at Waterloo Street, the water's so deep, people are being evacuated by boats.
We were still here when Derek Bird murdered 12 people, injured others, and shocked the whole of Britain.
We've just had some information in. This is pretty important. And we'll have more in our news at 12 today. But people in Whitehaven and Egremont are being urged to stay indoors following reports of a shooting in Whitehaven.
Armed police are looking for a man said to be in his 30s with a shaven head, driving a dark grey or silver Citroen Picasso.
John, good afternoon. Just tell us what happened to you earlier.
As I went in to see Skill, I saw a body lying on the pavement, partly in the road.
Our listeners have told us we're a lifeline, that we're worth every penny and that no one else can match the quality and service we provide. In times of crisis, we help bring our community together.
Good morning and welcome to our virtual service this Sunday morning here on BBC Radio Cumbria. In the next few minutes, we'll hear readings, reflections and prayers from people in many parts of the county flooded last week when our county was deluged by rain that saw flooding on an unprecedented scale.
And we were the only broadcasters to capture footballing history.
Referee looks at his watch, and up goes Jimmy Glass. Carlisle United goalkeeper, Jimmy Glass. The corner kick comes in. Oh, the goalkeeper's pass.
Jimmy Glass!
Jimmy Glass has scored! Jimmy Glass, the goalkeeper, has scored a goal for Carlisle United.
All of this happened here in Cumbria, hundreds of miles from our BBC broadcasting centres, and BBC Radio Cumbria was there not just for our listeners, but also providing clips, updates and contacts for the rest of the BBC.